Porte cazzone con un stemma a rete, una cupulella che vi si era aizzata, passa scampanianna pattuleta, con mano a papata fa guarda.
In classical tiramisu mixture, there are three mise en place. First one is tiramisu, which is a folded with mascarpone cheese. Second one is preparing savioli biscuit. For preparing savioli biscuit, it is also called as lady's finger. And coffee syrup is third mise en place. Now I am going to show you lady's finger recipe. Now lady's finger recipe, I have taken 80 grams of egg yolk and 120 grams of egg white. 2 pinches of salt, sugar 100 gram, and refined flour sieved 100 grams. First, I'll whisk only egg yolk at a high speed to as egg yolk starts whisking at a higher speed it will become I want to make egg yolk at a thicker spoon coating consistency. Till then I whisk the egg yolk at a high speed. Now second one is, in another bowl I have to make meringue using egg white and cashew sugar and a pinch of salt. Why I am going to add pinch of salt, I will tell you later. I am adding 2 pinches of salt. This I have to wait until the egg yolk becomes thicker and firm until spoon coating consistency. This is a raw egg. Now I am going to whisk at higher speed. Now you can observe the color has changed from dark yellowish color to light creamish color, and the mixture is becoming thicker. Now I'll stop and show you just to see the texture. You can see it's changed from dark yellowish color to light yellowish color, but it will become thicker, more thicker in texture. So I have to continue for 10 to 15 minutes it will take to make it thicker. Now I am going to start egg whites, because the egg yolk is started 8 minutes back. So now I will start at medium speed. I have added only salt, pinch of salt and egg white. Now I am going to increase at higher speed. When you see the egg white getting foamy texture, then you start adding cashew sugar into the egg white mixture. So now I can see foamy texture has started now. Now I am going to add cashew sugar at slowly in regular intervals of time. As earlier told you, salt is added in the egg white. Why? Because it will generate heat in the egg white and it will make you the meringue stiff, as well as the temperature will maintain when you are whisking the egg white at a higher speed, so that the temperature will hold the sugar and egg white mixture. Now whisk egg white and sugar till soft peak texture. So how to check soft peak texture? Using palette knife, use the soft peak when it is done. Meringue is getting done, so at regular intervals of time you have to check whether the meringue is attained soft peak or not. So I am going to stop the meringue mixture. Let me check using palette knife. So use palette knife, just press it in the mixture and just raise. Now you can see the bend kind of curve of the meringue. So this is called soft peak texture. So this is the time you have to stop the meringue texture. So I am going to stop now. Now for in this I have to fold egg yolk mixture. This mixture is has become thick of spoon coating. I'll show you how what is spoon coating. So this is the thick spoon coating texture. So I'm going to fold this one in meringue mixture. So let me fold the first egg white with the egg yolk mixture. Using rubber spatula, I'm going to fold, cut and fold technique. But please make sure you have to fold very quickly and fastly so that it will not go down the aerated meringue as well as the when you are folding the flour. So I will fold for cut and fold technique. Now I am going to fold the flour, sieved flour again. It's already sieved and I am doing second time. Immediately fold flour into the meringue mixture of egg white, sugar and egg yolk mixture. My lady's finger mixture is ready now. Make sure no lumps are there. So I'll show you no lumps. Now I'm going to fold this into the piping bag. Transfer the mixture immediately into the piping bag. I'm using plain nozzle of macaron size 1. And for baking ladies finger savoyardi biscuit also it is called. I am using silicone mat. Silicone mat is this for baking ladies finger. And on topping I have to dust it with icing sugar. Take sieve and icing sugar ready. Savoyardi shape of the savoyardi biscuit is 3 inches finger size. These I am going to use for garnish and remaining I have to use it for filling of the tiramisu mixture. So for this glass I am going to make a savoyardi biscuit in circular shape. So I will show you that one also. In second tray, I'll show you the filling of that one. First, let me dust it with icing sugar properly so that it will retain the color also. When you dust the icing sugar, it will give you the color also, like golden color. For garnish, now I am using for filling of the tiramisu mixture. So I'm making in circular savoyardi biscuits. Dust it properly with icing sugar. Savoyardi biscuit now I am going to bake at 220 degree centigrade, or you can take a temperature of 200 degree centigrade. If you are taking 220, it will take for up to 4 to 5 minutes. For 200 degrees it will take 60 to 7 minutes. So but In between, you have to check the temperature and the color of the savyadi should be light golden color. This is the top garnish for tiramisu. So it looks like a lady's finger. That's why the name has come, lady's finger. If it is golden brown in color, rare light golden brown in color, remove and cool it down. So this is what lady's finger baking properly. So you can see the garnishes also. Now this I am going to put it in a glass, old fashioned glass. So that's why I used round lady's finger. So I am scraping down with steel scraper. It is easy to remove scraping. Using scraper you will get lady's finger very, and these are very crisp and baked properly. Second mise en place for mascarpone cheese preparation, that is tiramisu preparation, is main preparation is egg white. I have to take 60 grams, along with that 25 grams of sugar, and egg yolk 100 grams I have taken to properly mix. Along with that 60 grams of sugar I have taken. Mascarpone cheese, which is the main ingredient in tiramisu mixture, is 250 grams I have taken. Also for cooking the sugar with soft boil, I have considered two heavy bottom vessels. Along with that I have taken ice bath to check the soft boil texture. Now first for egg yolk mixture, the 25 grams of sugar I am going to boil at a medium flame. With 25 gram means I am going to add 5 ml of to 10 ml of water, so that it will only soak properly, and then I'll start cooking the. Cook the sugar till soft boil temperature. The soft boil temperature will be 112 degrees centigrade. For small mixtures, the sugar thermometer will not be give you correct exact temperature. So I am using ice bath technology to use technique to use the how to check the soft boil temperature. Now for egg yolk I have starting the sugar cooking at a medium flame or slow flame. Now same time start beating the egg yolk with whisk at high speed. Soft boil temperature you have to check, but constantly you have to watch whether your sugar will come properly or not, otherwise you have to prepare again. So there is no alteration of sugar checking temperature. So let me check in ice bath my sugar soft boil has come or not. So I'll drop one drop of in a ice bath, and then I'll check with my finger. So it is almost done, soft boil has done. So now I'm going to transfer this sugar into whisking of the egg yolk. So continuously add. Now you can see it has attained cooking properly with soft boil. Egg yolk has attained saffron stage. This is the stage where you have to start egg white. So now I am going to start egg white. So this egg white also same procedure. Switch on the flame. Add 30 grams of sugar. Add 15 ml of water to just to soak the sugar. That's it. Now same way you cook this sugar also to till soft boil. Mix one time. I'm going to use again ice bath, so I'll keep it here. Simultaneously start egg white with medium flame. So this is the medium flame to start now. So by the time it attains soft boil stage, you have to add the soft boiled cooked sugar into the egg white mixture. So these two mixtures, until it cool downs and it attains soft peak, both the mixture should be whisked properly. Now please check soft boil stage. Same procedure you have to follow for egg yolk. Same way I am also using procedure for egg white, so that both will cook at egg white and egg yolk properly using the soft boiled sugar syrup. As egg yolk and egg white are started whisking at high speed, so that it will become attain the stage of sebion. Now this time you have to remove mascarpone cheese. Mascarpone cheese I have already taken 250 grams. So start making the cheese into soft texture. So using rubber spatula or spoon, both are ideal to use. So simple, just scrape down towards the sides of the dish using the palette knife or spoon. So it is very smooth and a little mascarpone cheese is always a soft cheese. So no need to whisk or no need to beat more than 30 seconds of time. So now my mascarpone cheese is already done. So no need to beat more than this. As I told you, sebion is a stage where you have to remove your egg yolk cooked with sugar syrup, soft boiled one. So now this is the stage where I have to remove. Just fold it into the mascarpone cheese. This is the time to check meringue also, that is egg white and cooked sugar. Remove from machine and check whether it has attained soft peak or not. Same way you have to check. So it is attained already. So now I am going to fold this meringue also into the mascarpone mixture. Now at this time also you can use whisk or rubber spatula, both are ideal one. Sebion of egg yolk as well as meringue of egg white is done and folded into the mascarpone cheese. This is a classical way of method to prepare tiramisu. Now I am going to chill this mixture until I pipe it in a old fashioned glass with the layered of Saviodi biscuit soaked with coffee syrup. The third mise en place of tiramisu is coffee syrup. Coffee syrup, I have to take espresso 60 ml, rum 20 ml, sugar syrup 60 ml, dark chocolate 20 grams. Now simple, I have to add in one mixing bowl to mix dark chocolate, espresso, rum. Rum I will add at the later because I have to cook 2 to 3 minutes of dark chocolate along with the sugar syrup. So I am adding dark chocolate. Except rum, melted chocolate, espresso and sugar syrup, please boil for one time so that chocolate will melt properly in the espresso and sugar syrup. And finally, you have to add coffee powder. I have already added coffee powder. Only the rum is left over. Now, if you don't have espresso syrup, the alternative is simple. Increase the sugar syrup with coffee powder and plain hot water is used if you don't have espresso syrup. Now, this mixture is ready. Chocolate is melted properly. Switch off the gas and then strain the mixture because chocolate have some lumps when you add with hot any mixture. So properly strain the mixture so that any lumps of the chocolate will remove from the syrup, coffee syrup. Rum is the final one which you have to add after cooking espresso, sugar syrup, coffee powder and espresso properly mixed with chocolate. Then remove from the flame, then only add. Otherwise what happens, rum will evaporate when you start cooking. So I am adding now into the coffee syrup. Now tiramisu mixture is ready. 3 mise en place are ready. First transfer the mixture of mascarpone mixture of tiramisu mixture into the piping bag for piping. So I am using piping bag with jet, measuring jet, so that it will stay for properly and you can pipe it easily. Now my second mise en place is lady's finger is ready, and third mise en place coffee syrup is ready. Now this is the time to layer the tiramisu. First I am going to soak first lady's finger off for the glass which I required. I am using this same which will fit into the glass of layered one. So now I am going to soak 10 to 20 seconds upside and downside also. Soak it properly and remove from syrup, and then just squeeze the excess coffee syrup from the lady's finger, not too much nor more. So now just simply transfer this into the, you can use either palette knife to just tuck it in the mold or glass. Now second layer will go with tiramisu mixture. Layer properly with tiramisu mixture and then leave it. So this way I'll continue second layer of the tiramisu mixture. Again soak it in lady's finger, again in coffee syrup, 10 to 20 seconds upside down. Remove excess coffee syrup from the lady's finger and then tuck it again. I'll use second layer also of the mixture. And then one more layer I'll start tucking. Soak it again with coffee syrup. Before I do, just tap the bowl or glass so that it will layer properly. And final layer. If you have excess, just remove using palette knife. Now follow similar way, you can follow the 3 more glasses what I have made the mixture. So it will come up to 3 glasses more. Finally tiramisu is ready and it is chilled properly. Keep in the fridge for nearly 30 to 40 minutes, then you remove and serve a la carte. So just I'll dust it half moon shape and then I'll use lady's finger and then place it at first. One plate I have done already, and second plate also I'll show you. This is the final presentation, and this is served chilled, as tiramisu is a cold dessert, and served with sabayodi biscuit on top of it. Portega su una con un stemma rete.